Now let's go through the phototransduction cascade. When light enters the eye, it travels past the ganglionic cell layer and the interneuron layers until it reaches the photoreceptor layer and the pigmented layer deep in the retina. In the photoreceptors, light is absorbed by rhodopsin proteins in rods and photopsin proteins in cones. Rhodopsin and photopsin are both G-protein-coupled receptors and are in the opsin family. G-protein-coupled receptors are cell surface receptors that receive a signal from outside of the cell and trigger changes within the cell. When the opsin proteins, rhodopsin and photopsin, are struck by photons, a protein called retinol changes shape or isomerizes from 11 cis retinol to 11 trans retinol, creating a conformational change in the opsin proteins. That causes the opsin proteins to activate G proteins called transducins, or GT, which in turn activate the enzyme phosphodiesterase. Phosphodiesterase converts cyclic guanosine monophosphate, or cGMP, to 5-guanosine monophosphate. Now, normally rods and cones have sodium channels, which are bound to cGMP, that allow sodium to continuously flow into the cell. When phosphodiesterase converts cyclic GMP to 5-guanosine monophosphate, there's less cyclic GMP within the cell available to bind sodium channels. Therefore, the sodium channels close. This decreases the inward current of sodium entering the cell, and the photoreceptor becomes more negative, or hyperpolarized. When photoreceptors are hyperpolarized, they stop sending action potentials down to the synaptic terminal, and that closes the voltage-gated calcium ion channels near the synaptic terminal. As a result, there's less of the excitatory neurotransmitter glutamate released into the synapse between the photoreceptor and bipolar cell. So, in essence, when light triggers a photoreceptor, it turns off and stops releasing neurotransmitters. Interestingly, it's the lack of glutamate that causes the bipolar cell to open up its voltage-gated calcium channels and depolarize. And the bipolar cell then triggers depolarization of the ganglion cell. And from there, the action potential is propagated along the optic nerve, and ultimately to the primary processing centers in the brain in the occipital lobe.